Lightfall is less than 2 months away, and while that sounds like a long amount of time, it will sneak up on us. One of the reasons you're going to want to start the bounty prep it now, if you want to be serious about getting into day one raid and getting the mods that you need for builds early, is that there are some bounties that are on a 6-week rotation that are XP++. So again, if you want on day one to be able to get over 3 million XP and to get the best seasonal mods on day one, you're going to want to check this video out now. Also, I'm going to include a spreadsheet that will allow you to see the methodology that using the bounty prep that I'm talking about right now, you'll be able again to get 3 million XP within the first few hours of playing on day one. Hi, I'm Part-Time Guardian. For those who are new to my channel, feel free to check out my other videos and subscribe if you haven't already, because that allows me to put out great content, specifically new player guides, returning player guides, tips and tricks, raid and dungeon and build guides. You'll see all of those on this channel. In addition, if you'd like to see these videos earlier, feel free to join my channel for YouTube members. I will be posting for the majority of videos earlier than I will for everyone else, so you get a sneak peek and can come in and comment and help me to make greater videos for the community. So first off, if it's not clear already, the way that bounties work in Destiny 2 these days are XP++, XP+, and XP. Your XP++ are your 12K, your XP+ are your 6K. Those are the only things you're going to need to be concerned about going to the next season. The other key is while you're getting the XP++ ones done, you can also work on XP+ bounties that are in the same area. Let me walk you through what some of the key ones are. There are 4 XP++ bounties that you can get either from the Lectern or from Eris. And again, while you're doing these, you can also be getting XP+ bounties as well, because the ones on the moon are very, very simple and easy to do. The Cosmodrome has 2 XP++, again, which are really simple. And at the same time, you can be also getting XP+ bounties at the same time. The Dreaming City actually has 7, and most people who've watched this video really, wait, 7? How's that possible? Well, you have the one for the Blind Well, but you also have one each week for the Ascended Challenge. The Ascended Challenge has a different name each week, the actual bounty, so you can actually do 6 of these. It just requires doing what are relatively easy challenges on each of your characters. Xur has 1, so again, if you have the 30th Anniversary Edition, you should be able to do that. Europa has a total of 4. First off, it has a standard one for doing patrols and things like that, but then it has a 1 for each of the 3 Empire Hunts, which again, happen on a weekly rotation. And then Hawthorne has a total of 8, but they rotate through. So they're 3 for Crucible, 3 for Gambit, 1 for Raid, 1 for Nightfall, and these you have to do with your clan. So if you total those up together, that is a total of 26 XP++ bounties, which again, are going to give you a big jump start on the competition. And because the Dreaming City one is on a 6-week rotation, you really need to start now if you want to get these complete it in time for the next season. In addition, what I would recommend then is, because you have 63 slots for your bounties, you want to leave a few of those free, because you don't want to fill everything up, right? Because if you fill everything up, then if you have quests or other things you have to pick up in the next season, you won't have space for them, and it's just going to be a pain to kind of deal with. So what I would do in addition is I would pick up 7 XP+ bounties from each of the core activities, Crucible, Vanguard, Gambit. That'll make it easier next season when you want to do an additional bounty in the next season to actually get the weekly challenges done and to get your powerfuls and to also get the extra XP from that. So I would do that. So if you do that in total, that's gonna be a total of 47 bounties. What I would do in addition to that then is then take 13 bounties from anywhere. Again, you could have done it from one of these areas. I would be doing it while you're doing your moon bounties, your Cosmodrome, or one of those areas. Just get XP+. That in total will take you to 60. Now, with that and doing the seasonal challenges in the next season, you'll be able to, within the first day or so, be able to get all the way to the end of your seasonal track. And then because of that, you'll have all the mods that you'll be able to do all the cool builds and things that you will see on this channel and other channels. That's really the video, guys. I want to make it short and sweet, but I want to also make sure you understand that if you do want to do the prep, do it now. Don't kill yourself. But each of these are fairly easy to do. Just require some time every week and you save them up and get a jump start next season. That's the video. If you like the video, feel free to like it. Subscribe to my channel, join my Discord, and I'll see you Guardians in the Tower.